Once upon a time, a king called Indradyumna ruled central India. He was a great devotee of Lord Vishnu and had an ardent desire to see him. One day, a traveling mendicant came visiting the court and told him that Vishnu was worshipped in his truest form as Neel Madhav in Odisha. The king immediately ordered the head priest's brother Vidyapati to head to Odisha in search of Neel Madhav. After a long, tiring journey, Vidyapati reached Odisha. There, he found the tribal chieftain Vishwavasu secretly guarding Neel Madhav. He pleaded Vishwavasu to show him the place of worship, but the tribal chieftain refused. Vidyapati continued to stay in the village. Eventually, he fell in love with Vishwavasu's daughter and in time got married to her. Soon after the wedding, Vidyapati cajoled his wife to convince his father-in-law for just one glimpse of Neel Madhav. On his daughter's insistence, Vishwavasu finally agreed, but on one condition. Vidyapati would be taken blindfolded. But Vidyapati managed to outsmart the tribal chieftain. On his way, he dropped mustard seeds to later track his way back with the king. Upon reaching the secret cave, once the blindfold was removed, Vidyapati was spellbound to see the most magnificent image of Neel Madhav. He rushed back to tell his king, who at once set forth to catch a glimpse of his beloved lord. But later, when the king reached the cave with Vidyapati, he found it to be empty. Neel Madhav had disappeared. The king was devastated. But he received a divine vision that he should go to Puri and draw ashore a log of wood which would be floating on the waves. The king obeyed and found a log floating on the shores of Puri. Ecstatic, he brought it to the palace, only to face a greater challenge. No one could carve through that hard wood, and since no one else had seen Vishnu, no one could carve the figure in his likeness. When the task was getting impossible to execute, Vishwakarma, the artisan of the gods, appeared in the guise of an old carpenter. He convinced the king that he could carve out the idols on the condition that no one should disturb him for 21 days. The king readily agreed. After the 15th day, the queen grew impatient and persuaded the king to open the door. There, to his dismay, he saw that the carpenter had disappeared, only to leave behind wooden images in their incomplete form. And it is believed that the same form of these iconic wooden idols is housed in the famous Jagannath temple in Puri.